So in this video, I'm going to show you a couple techniques, just pieces of them. You can see the picture over there to the right is a picture of a real rose, and I wanted to paint the rose. And one of the things I do to paint like the masters is to do layers and layers and layers. I don't do 30 layers and stuff like they did. I just don't have the patience for that. But I did do several layers on this rose because I wanted to get a very rich red and I wanted it to look very realistic. So as you can see here, these are the paints that I use. And they are mostly Winston, and Grumbacher. So I had to order my oil Grumbacher because Michaels doesn't carry it. But these are the paints that I'm using. And I also use the Master's Touch, which is the white one you see there. That's the Master's Touch. You can get that at Hobby Lobby. So these are the paints that I'm using. And for this, you can see the colors I'm using. I'm using Cad Red Light, Cad Red Deep Hue, white, and a titanium white is one of them. And I can't remember the other white. And then Rose Red, which is the Grumbacher there, and Payne's Gray. Payne's Gray is really big for me. I use it for my shading in the darkest parts. And then I also did add black to some parts of the rose. But I tried to use most of it with the rose red and the Payne's Gray mixed together to make a very dark, dark red. But I did add black into the deepest parts of the shadows. You can see the medium that I use there is the small yellow looking one, which you can find at any arts and crafts store. So as you can see, I start out with a drawing, and I use a charcoal drawing, and I do all my shading. This kind of helps me because when I paint over it, I can see the areas that I need to be shaded. So I'm not good at drawing at all. I have to use a grid. I take the picture that I print of the real life version of the rose, and then I just start drawing from that. So this is the most difficult part for me, is getting the drawing right and the perspective right and all the pieces in place. But it's important because I have to get my shading in the right place. Once I have all my shading in and my drawing to scale the way it should be, I start adding the color. So you can see that I put in just a layer of red and black. I used all my different colors. So I did a blend of Payne's Gray with the Deep Hue Red. And then I did a mixture of Deep Hue Red and the Cad Red Light. And then I did a mixture of the Rose Red by Grumbacher and added that to Payne's Gray. So I did quite a lot of mixtures. And then there was times when I just put some white in with some of my different reds to give the very lighter areas. So this is a very rough beginning. And then you can see I put a whole layer across the entire rose. So now I've got my layer down and I've got my shading down. The most important thing is that I've got that shading in there. And it looks very rough. It's not blended well. But I need this layer and I let it dry for 3 days. So I have it for sure. It's not going anywhere. I'm not going to blend it out. I'm not going to lose it. From now on, this is the most important layer because that shading is always going to show through. So I'm going to begin adding my layers. Just like the masters do, and I'm sorry that the lighting looks different here because it's a different time of day. It's a different day, actually. I want to make this a very vibrant red rose. I want it to be very rich. So I'm going to start putting my layers on. So the first thing I'm going to do is start petal by petal. And I'm not going to show you the whole thing, of course, or all the layers. But here's my first layer that I'm doing. And you can see that I took the Cad Red Deep Hue and I added it to the Cad Red Light. So that's what I'm adding right now. And I'm putting it over top of the whole thing. So I'm putting it over the whiter areas and the medium areas. But because I have such a nice underlayer it's just going to, those shadows are just going to keep showing through. So I won't lose my brighter spots. So I'm just going to keep going over top of the whole area there. But when I go over to where it's shaded, you're going to see that I will. So I'm showing you the colors I'm using here. That's the Cad Red Light, and the Deep Hue is over to the left. I'm sorry, my hand is in the way. And when I go into the deeper ones, that's when I'm going to start adding the rose red. And I'm going to maybe combine the rose red and the deep red. And when I really need it to be dark, I add the Payne's Gray. Payne's Gray is a great color to use for blending and darkening any shade and dulling it down a little, giving it a more matted look. The Payne's Gray is translucent, yet it darkens a color so quickly. So it's really good for mixing. Black is not a good color to mix when you want to deepen red or something because it's too opaque. It's kind of like using zinc white instead of titanium white because titanium is so opaque. So now I'm speeding up the video a little bit. I didn't speed it up like most videos, so this is going to be a slow process for you to watch because for me, when I watch somebody speed it up to like 500 times what it is, I can't really see how they're blending or what they're doing. So I only sped this up a little bit. It's at 160 instead of 100. So this way you can see 100% would just be normal speed. So I bumped it up to 160 so it's not too long and boring for you. But I want you to be able to see how I blend everything. So you see how I'm going right over that shadow to the right there. I'm just taking the same color and going over both parts, the light and the dark, and that's what's giving me. So now I'm switching to darker colors. So I'm showing you that I'm doing the deep red hue, and I'm actually adding some Payne's gray to it. Or actually, no, this is all just deep red hue going over top of the shadow. So I'm staying in the shadow area, and eventually I'm going to blend between those two colors. See how I go a little bit into the lighter color, and I'm going to make a blend right there between the dark and the light. Of the two colors on each layer. I'm going to do this with every layer. So I'm laying down the dark part first. And another thing I want to point out is that I don't clean my brush in between. So I just take a paper towel and I wipe off as much as I can and then I put the next shade on. So I'm pretty much working most of the time with the same brush. Now, occasionally I need to get down to something tinier, so I'll have to use a smaller brush. Or if I'm doing a very large area and I don't want paintbrush strokes showing, I will use a fatter brush. For the most part, I'm using this brush for almost for the entire painting. So now I'm going back to my lighter color, medium. So it's the deep hue and the Cad Red Light. So it's giving me like the medium. And this is really the main color red that I want the whole flower to be. So I use it a lot on this rose for my layers that come after this. As I was looking at the painting tonight, I do want to go ahead and do some more layers, even though I've already put a lot of water droplets on. The left side of the rose doesn't have water droplets yet, so I think I'm going to do even more layers over there. So, okay, so you see this is a shaded area, so it gives you the indication of a dip in the petal. And I'm just going over it with that same favorite color that I have. Look how rich that is. Do you see that? So it's the kind of red rose that is my favorite. Absolutely love it. And you can see I'm just putting it over, even the light areas, just going over with the same color. So it's that same deep red hue, Cad Red Light mixed together. I'm going over both light and dark with it. Now you see I'm going to avoid that dark area there because I'm actually going to go over that dark area with more of the rose red and Payne's gray. So where you see it get really black, that's where I'm going to start mixing in rose red and Payne's gray. So here on this one, I'm only using Cad Red Light. So the very, very light, bright spots that I want to show, like that one, I'm only using Cad Red Light. So I didn't add any of the dark hue there. So I'm going over that area with just the Cad Light. So I do change my shades because you have to keep stepping back and looking at the rose. And I know there's spots that I'm going to have much brighter where I really expect the light to be hitting it. So of course you're going to change your shade. You're not always going to do the same shade over your entire underpainting. Another thing I want to add is that with the underpainting, normally I do a sepia underpainting, which is what the masters did. They would do the whole entire painting in sepia first in great detail. then just go over it with medium and colors added to it, almost like clear coats going over, clear coats of color going over and over and over. And that's really good if you're doing a person. So if I'm doing portraits with faces, which I'm going to do another video and show you a face and what I do with those layers, once you've got the shades down and the skin tones down, it's great to go over with just those layers of colored clear coats, almost, I want to call it, because it just gives the depth to the skin when you're looking through. You see the veins and you see the different colorations of the skin. That's great for people. But this is a portrait of a flower. So I'm doing more. I didn't do the sepia color underneath. But however, I have to say that the charcoal that I used was sepia. And I don't use pencil and I don't use black to draw my paintings because it's too hard to cover up for me. I like the sepia tones. Okay, so you can see here I'm going over, and now I put a lot of white there because I wanted that to stay lit up on the edge, and you see how that works? So it's a darker pink on the edge, but it's staying very light because of the white that I'd mixed in it earlier. And I wouldn't know this if I wasn't looking at a real rose. The backlight is hitting that petal that's going around the back side of the rose here, that's kind of shaded by the upper petals. So it's not going to be the kind of lit up petal that the others are, because it's getting more of a backlight to it. So I love that dimension and the total different colors. So here, what I'm trying to show you is the dark
For
colors
these
that I'm
darker
really using.
areas,
I'm using the Payne's Gray mixed with the deep, or the rose color, which is made by Grombucker. It's rose red. And that way I get the much deeper red. I don't want pure black on the petals, especially the ones that are not seeping down into the rose. Like the ones that are going straight down into the center, yeah, I do fade those into black. But out here, I'm just going to keep adding the rose red and the Payne's Gray. And I don't have a lot of Payne's Gray in this mixture, let you know now. That's mostly the rose red. The rose red's dark, but not dark enough. So I do add a little bit of the Payne's Gray. Now I think I'm going to come down. Oh, let's see. Yeah, so this really big dip in, and it's a sharp dip in the leaf, in the petal. So I'm going to go straight into it with my dark color. So back, that's the rose red. And then a little bit of Payne's Gray. And mix those together till I get a nice dark red. And go over top of that. See, so this is going to cover up the other layers of brush strokes, because remember the Payne's Gray is a bit translucent. So when you, that first layer, you can see a lot. So I'm trying to make it a little more solid. And you just got to be patient. You got to do this layer by layer. You got to let it dry for 3 days and then come back and do another layer. And that's why oil paintings are so rich. You just have to be patient and build your painting. If you want it to be like the kind of things you see in museums, especially the oil paintings, that's the style that I like. And I'm showing you here that I'm just wiping my brush off. I don't clean my brush in between. And I go back to my lighter shade with the same brush, and it's fine. So now I'm going to, I don't want to lose that very distinct dark dip in the petal. So when I blend these, I'm going to be very careful how I blend it. So I'm coming close to it, but you see I'm not quite going into it with the lighter color, because it's a very definite dark spot in the flower. And now as I go over this spot right there, as I go over that, I am getting really light with my pressure. I'm gliding the brush over those two colors so that it's a soft brush that I'm using to begin with, and it's a very soft stroke. So I'm bringing the two colors together. I'm moving them together is actually what I'm doing. I'm lightly, lightly moving them together. So you're not digging your brush in, you're not putting a lot of pressure. I am wisping, wisping over the top of the canvas. Okay, so now this is just straight cad light, cad red light, because these areas I have to keep very light. And I want those two petals to stay distinct from each other. And it's basically the same thing. I'm going to go down there and I'm going to blend that curve of dark up into the light. So I'm pulling the color down and I'm going to come back with a dark color and blend it into it. Okay, so now I'm moving over to, I'm going to show you where I'm really going to deepen this over here. So this is just the deep hue, cad red deep. Okay, and that's going over that area there. And you see I'm staying in the area that's supposed to be like the medium value. Okay, and I will spread it out over that lighter area because that lighter area is just barely getting light on the tip of the petal. So I'm going to move over this area slowly. You see, I'm being very careful not to just overlap my dark areas. I'm going to keep my black areas very black. Okay. So now that white that I put in the underpainting is just going to keep that light enough. It's just perfect. Underpainting is so important. Okay, and I'm staying away from that line. Okay, I'm going right over it. Forgot I did that. Okay, I'm going again into this area that needs the darker hue. Really depending on my underpainting here. See how critical that underpainting is. If you don't get it right, your painting won't be right. I mean, you can fix it later with other layers, but it just makes it so much easier to have it correct to start with. Okay, this is all the dark here. And just because it's going over a lighter underpainting, it's staying lighter. I'm making sure I'm trying really hard not to go into the black there, because I don't want any hazy look on my black. Where these petals are going straight into the center of the rose, I want that black area to stay very dark. But I do want you to see those traces of the leaf disappearing or the petal disappearing into the darkness, which I think I've done pretty well with this painting. It really gives you that vertical look. Here again, I'm using the medium value, which is really just my deep hue red. And I should note too that I'm adding a little bit of medium to this. It's not straight out of the tube. So the medium gives it more of a clear coat effect. So it's the color, but it's a see-through version of the color, sort of. That's the way I see it. Okay, so because I have that look, I'm going to overlap the black just a little bit because I want that depth, that perception of the petal going down into the center of the rose. I don't want to lose that effect that I've got going there. Okay, now I'm going to start darkening the inner petals because they really should be darker. They catch light. There's some lighter spots, but they need to be darker than those outer petals. So I'm coming in here and I'm putting the deep hue into these center petals because they're just too light. They definitely need to be deepened. And that's what's going to give me that rich red rose when I'm done. You see how that underpainting just makes it so easy. So that's where your skill really has to come in. You just have to pay attention to the real flower the whole time you're painting. You got to keep referencing the real thing so you get those light and dark areas correct. And see how you go over that, and just it comes out so rich. How beautiful that is. See, it's just adding color, layers on layers, and color. There's a point too, and I'm not going to show you in this video, where I go back in over the black too, and I make the black even deeper. And believe it or not, it can get richer and deeper, so it's not as flat. So after I do all the red, I wait days again till that's dry, and then I go back over the black again, and I deepen the very center of the black, the depth, the deepest parts of it. Look how nicely that just brings that rose to life, just adds that color that it needs, yet keeps all the light areas how they should be. See, and I'm going to go down to the black there because I want that petal to look like it's going straight down and fading into that dark abyss. So it's important to have just a mixture of a little bit of the red, the deep red over the black areas. And of course, the first layer is where I really blended them. So if you look at the right side of the center of the rose there, not where I'm painting, but over to the right, you can see that how the rose is disappearing. You can see the red, and you just faintly see that red going into the black. Yeah, I'm going to do it too. I'm going to go right down to the black area down there. You can just see that red fading into the darkness. And it's so important to have that, give it that three-dimensional look. So I'm going to keep a very soft stroke when I'm doing this because I don't want to show any paintbrush lines, and that's really how I do that. I don't push hard on my brush at all at this point. I do with the first layer when I'm doing my shading, but at this point I'm glazing. It's really what I'm doing at this stage of the painting. And the more you glaze it, the better. See, now this is where I'm taking that. This is just pure rose red here. And going over those areas. And that's the area I'm talking about that really gives an indication of the petal still going down further, but you can't see it. It's really deep in the rose. And so it's just a hint of the red going down into the abyss there. Really gives it that straight down look. It's one of my favorite parts of this painting. Because this is such a big canvas, you see it moving. It doesn't have a solid back, it has crossbars behind it, so it's kind of hard to keep it from moving. And there's so many parts on it that are wet now, I can't like hold it with my hand to hold it still because I've got to be careful what I touch. When you see me go away, I'm mixing and I'm getting a little more medium, I'm keeping my paint light. I'm trying to keep it not very thick. So now I'm coming in with a little bit of a lighter color that I'm using down below in the darkness there. And I think I have a lot of medium in this, so that it stays very clear because I don't want to lose that touch of light right there. It's real important on this petal. That petal in particular is one of my favorite. So now I'm going back to the deep hue. I'm going into that pocket with deeper red over that shadow. I'm coming over to this side. I'm just highlighting the very brightest parts. So I'm using the very chiseled edge of the brush. Again, I'm using that same brush. I'm kind of surprised I did. And just getting the edge where it's the brightest. So you see I'm using nothing but cad red light, not mixing anything with it, so it's my lightest value. I don't mix white with any of my reds at this stage. I did that with the underpainting, but not any of these layers. I'm trying to just stay on the very edge right now with this very bright color. Now I'm blending. I'm using the deep hue there. That's that one. And you see I'm going right over all my shadows because this covers it just fine and still lets the shadows show, so you still get that effect of the petal going deep into the rose, straight down. Again, like I've said before, it's one of my favorite parts of the painting, is the way the petals just go straight down. It makes it really so pretty. So now I'm going to add water droplets, and I've already added quite a few, but I'm going to go down to the bottom and show you how I did it. So we're zooming in this area here, and this in particular is difficult to do. You've probably watched tutorials before on painting water droplets, and there's this formula where they do white and they do black, and blend out the white and blend out the black, and you're done. You have a water droplet, and those look great, and those tutorials are good, and I'm not putting those down, but if you really want a true water droplet, think about it. It has to reflect the colors. You can't just use white and black to do a water droplet, though it does pass and it does look good. So what I'm showing you here is I'm really spending the time to blend and bring in the colors of the rose. So around it, look at what you have. You've got deep reds, you've got bright reds, and you've got white light. Okay, so definitely we're gonna have white. And you can see now I first put on a circle. I just draw the circle of where I want it in my cad red light. Now I'm going in and I'm adding white. So don't be afraid. You can always go back and you're gonna see I'm gonna go back and fix this. So I'm adding white to the top and I'm blending it in with the red that I put on first. Okay, so the top part of this bubble, because the two above it, the water droplets, are underneath a leaf or a petal, you're not going to see as much white. But these are spot on. The white is right on top of them. So what I'm doing is I'm adding more black right now, and I'm going to blend that black. And I am using black because when you look through water, and if you look at the actual rose that I'm looking at, it distorts or makes like an arc of color. So that black that's being caught in the water droplet is arched. It's more. It almost looks like it's cutting into the petal there. So I had to add more black. Not too much. So now I'm doing the white at the bottom because when the light shines through, the white is going to reflect on the bottom of these water droplets. So you're going to see a very white area. So now I'm going in and I'm going to blend. And you have to go back and forth. So I'm blending the black into the white, or the white into the black right now. And that's going to look great. And I'm going to get the edge that I need. See, I'm blending the colors into the black. But I'm going to need to go back with the black and blend back out. And that's what I'm doing right now. So I'm putting more black in because it actually needs to show the arc. Amplifies the black to a bigger part of the circle. Okay, so I'm going in, and actually that water droplet, if it's really sitting the way it should be much flatter on the bottom and not so circular, which I'm going to fix in a minute. Okay. So you see, right. Now I'm just going to let you watch the rest. It's just a bunch of blending, but watch in particular how I flatten out the bottom of that bubble. And also I'm going to add reflection, which on the petal itself, which is really cool. And it's a great technique.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears have gone. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child.
Yeah. speak to me. I want to feel you. I need to hear you. You are the light that's leading me to the Tell me, how could it be any better?